हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू GCA। आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड डूइंग योर प्रेपरेशन फॉर योर SSB। एंड आई एम अगेन बैक विद अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट वीडियो टू हेल्प यू इन योर प्रेपरेशन। सो फ्रॉम टुडे आई एम स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू सीरीज़ एज यू रेड फ्रॉम द टाइटल, द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस ऑन आर्मी दैट आर आस्क्ड इन द SSB इंटरव्यू। दिस सीरीज विल कंटेन द 50 रियल लाइफ SSB क्वेश्चंस ऑन आर्म्ड फोर्सेज एंड आई विल कवर दिस 50 क्वेश्चंस इन 3 वीडियोज, दैट इज इन पार्ट 1 एंड पार्ट 2। There is going to be 15 questions each, and in part 3 there will be 20 to 22 questions. So these are the real life SSB questions which you should know before going to the SSB, because having knowledge, a good knowledge about the armed forces, reflects your motivation and passion to join the armed forces. So again, without wasting any time, let us start. But let me tell you friends, before starting this video, that here I will only give the brief introduction, that is the brief description of the particular question. And in order to know more in detail, you should check internet or follow any source. So let us start. So the very first question is, what are the ranks of the Indian Army and the equivalent ranks? So the question can be asked like, tell me the ranks of the Indian Army officers from the lieutenant till the highest rank, that is of the field marshal. Whereas on the other side, the question can also be like this, tell me the ranks of the Indian Army by comparing with other service ranks, like what are the equivalent ranks. For example, the rank of the major in the army is equivalent to what in Navy and what in Air Force. So moving to the second question. So the second question that is generally asked is, how many commands are there in the army and their specific location? So here I am covering about the army interview. If you are going for Navy and Air Force interview, you should know about the commands and the location of Navy and Air Force also. So for Army, there are total of 7 commands, 6 operational commands and 1 training command, which is at Shimla. The question can be like, tell me the names of the commands and their specific location. Whereas on the other side, the question can also be like this, tell me the nearest command to your hometown. For example, if you are living in Punjab, then it comes under the Western Command, then your answer should be like, sir, the nearest command to my hometown is Western Command, which is at Chandibandar Kent, Chandigarh. Moving to the third question. So this is a very important question that is always asked, and whether you are a fresher or a repeater, what are the arms and the services of the Indian Army? Arms are basically the elements that fight front to front with the enemy, and the services, these are the elements that supports the fighting element. The arms include infantry, armored corps, mechanized infantry, and along with this there are supporting arms, which is the artillery, engineers, corps of signals, army aviation corps and air defense artillery. Similarly in services, there is EME, ASC, AOC, that is the army ordnance corps, army medical corps, army education corps and army intelligence corps. If you want a complete knowledge about the arms and the services, my videos are already available. You can find the link in I button. Moving to the fourth question, what is the difference between infantry and mechanized infantry? Talking about infantry first, infantry basically, these are the soldiers on the foot that fight front to front with the enemy. These are also involved in the CI operations, and during war also they hold defenses, and by using various types of gun. For example, they uses different type of gun like Insass rifle, LMG, AK-47 and other weapons like rocket launchers, mortars, grenade launchers. So these consist of the highest proportion of the overall Indian Army. And talking about the mechanized infantry, this is a combination of the mechanization and infantry. That is, it uses BMPs, which are basically the infantry fighting vehicles, and they fight along with the armored corps. And this is known as a mechanized infantry. As I already said, this is a combination of infantry and mechanized. That is, along with the BMP, it can carry a section of infantry also. That is, along with this, it can carry around 10 soldiers and fight along with the armored corps. Moving to the next question. So the next question is, name the tanks held with the armored corps. So over the years, Indian Armored Corps have operated various tanks, including the Centurion tank, Vijayanta tank, and at present, there is T-72 tank, T-90 tank, Arjun Mark 1, and Arjun Mark 2, which is soon to be deployed. So this question is asked normally to the candidates who says they want to be a part of the Indian Armored Corps, that is, they want to join the Indian Armored Corps. So the next question is, next is, what is AFSPA, that is the Armed Forces Special Power Act? This is a very, very important question which you should know before going to the SSB This is important not only in interview but from the lecturer point of view also. So the Armed Forces Special Power Act, it is an act which comes into effect when all the other forces available to the state have failed to put the situation under control. And this act only comes into effect when the area is declared as a disturbed by the central with the consent of state government. So very soon I'm coming up a detailed video on this topic, that is the Armed Forces Special Power Act. So moving to the next question. So the next question is a tricky question which many of you might not be aware of this. And this question was asked to one of my friends who got recommended last year. The question is, name the arm of the Indian Army which uses BMPs other than the mechanized infantry. And the answer is Brigade of Guards. The next question is, name of the service chiefs. So whether you are going for Army, Navy or Air Force, you should be aware of the name of service chiefs of three services. And along with this, you should also know the vice chiefs of the services. And the next question is, so where is the Regimental Center of Artillery and the Armored Corps? For the artillery, it is known as School of Artillery and it is at Devlali Camp, Nasik. And for the Armored Corps, it is known as the Armored Corps School and Center, which is at Ahmednagar, Maharashtra. And this question can be asked to the candidates who aspires to join artillery or the Armored Corps, or their father is serving in the artillery or the Armored Corps. Moving to the next question. So this is a very important question. Where is Siachen Glacier and its significance? So Siachen Glacier is in the eastern Karakoram Ranges, and that is on the left side of NJ9842 map coordinates. And its significance is that it creates a wedge between Pakistan and China, and it provides a strategic advantage to India. And its melting water is a main source of Indus River, which feeds the Punjab plains of India and Pakistan. If you want to know about detail in about the Siachen Glacier and its significance, my video is already available, so you can find the link in the I button and know this topic in detail. So the next question is, what is INSAS stands for? Or it can also be like, what is the full form of INSAS? INSAS stands for Indian Small Arms System, and it is a family of infantry system that consists of an assault rifle and a light machine gun. The question can also be asked like, what is the standard weapon of the Indian Armed Forces? So you have to say it is the INSAS, which consists of two rifles, that is the AR and the light machine gun. Next question is, so name 10 joint exercises of the Indian Armed Forces, and the data is available, you can prepare from this. The question can also be like, tell me the recent joint exercises that have been conducted this year. So you should be aware of this. And along with this, the question can also be like, tell me the name of tri-services exercise, that is the Malabar exercise. So you should be aware of which are the countries that participate in Malabar exercise. Next question is, tell me something about the operations of the Indian Army. So like we all are aware that since the independence, Indian Army has fought various operations, including the four wars, three with Pakistan and one with China, and other operations have already been mentioned here, so you can read from this. Now this is as the period of lockdown is going on, we all are free, so invest your time in knowing about the operations in detail. At least you should know about the five operations in detail. Although this question might not be asked, but in order to increase your knowledge, you should know about this. Next is, what is LOC and LAC stands for, and where is LOC and LAC? This question was asked to my SSB friend in Allahabad for the NCC entry. So in order to confuse you, the IO might ask you this question again by telling like, no, this is not the exact location of the LOC or LAC. So you should know this in detail. Although the definition of LOC and LAC have already been mentioned, so you can prepare from this, and in order to know more about this, you can search on Google. Moving to the last question of this first part. So which regiment do you want to join and why? This is a very, very important question, because in order to check your awareness, IO might ask you, because if you are a passionate, then you have already decided which regiment, which arm or service you want to join. So please then friends, watch my previous video. I have mentioned everything in detail about the which regiment, and if you are confused how to choose the regiment, you after watching that video, your doubt will be clear, because I have also mentioned the factors which you should consider before choosing the arm or the service you want to join. So friends, this was all about the part 1 of the basic army important questions. I hope you have found this beneficial for you. So stay tuned for part 2. And tell me in the comment section that how many questions you were already aware of this 15 questions. So that's it. Thank you, friends. God bless you.